poignant ceremonies have been held across the UK for the victims of war. Queen Elizabeth, accompanied by other members of the royal family, led the annual Remembrance Day commemorations at the Cenotaph in central London as large crowds lined the streets. This year marks the 100th anniversary of the start of World War I and 70 years since the D-Day landings. Representatives from Commonwealth countries also laid wreaths, as for the first time did the Irish ambassador. The UK government paid tribute to the thousands of Irish personnel who'd served in the British Armed Forces. Veterans from the Second World War joined thousands of current servicemen and women who took part in the march. Despite the prominence given to previous wars, the thoughts of many were with the victims of more recent conflicts. Security was especially tight. Last week, four men were arrested, police said, as part of an ongoing inquiry into Islamist-related terrorism. In Afghanistan, where Britain is ending its combat role, Prince Harry led the commemorations in Kandahar. More than 450 British soldiers have been killed and many others wounded in the 13-year struggle against the Taliban.